I've been playing sports ever since I was a kid. My brother was the one that was always around, and he was the one that introduced me to skiing when I was like 3 months old. So I've always been into sports pretty much since I was born. Started ski racing up at Mount Bachelor, then met a coach and he wanted me to start racing. Racing ever since then. I've had a total of 12 concussions. The first six were from ski racing, and after that, just being a kid, playing soccer, and just other accidents, I've gotten more concussions over the years, but they weren't diagnosed. I just laid low. I took myself out of sports for a few days just till I felt better. I never really took the time to heal that I needed. There's just a lot of pain associated with a head injury, and it's more than just the physical pain, it's the emotional pain. I finally found a doctor. He just told me I had post-concussion syndrome, and at that time I couldn't believe it because I was on the road to go to the Olympics and I thought I could get there. The migraine is so unbelievably painful. You can't fix pain for concussions, you can't. There's no drugs that help that. And that's probably the worst. Your brain connections are being stopped. They're being cut off. And so you're irritable because you can't understand what's going on with the world. Your brain can't keep up with the processing. With a concussion, your brain is processing everything. So your brain's getting tired. You're getting irritable, and I would get angry. Letting my brain heal by sleeping and not hitting my head, so not doing sports, allowed these brain pathways to go around these blocks. And I was one of the lucky ones that was able to have my brain remapped with intensive physical therapy, intensive cognitive therapy, and intensive eye therapy. The symptoms can go on and on and on. Everybody experiences them differently. The pain literally makes you do insane things, because you just don't think there's a way out. There's a very tiny light at the end of that tunnel, and you have to find it, and when you can't find it, there's nothing else. And it's more than just the physical pain, it's the emotional pain. The one thing I found very important in this whole recovery is my family and my friends. Through going to a therapist, I was able to get rid of my depression completely within 8 months. And after that, everything else just started rolling. I realized that once I got over my depression, my symptoms were going away. At the beginning of my recovery, I was taking 3 credits a term. I am back on track for graduation, and I'm basically doing the impossible. I am going to graduate college in about 2 years, and my doctors told me I wouldn't be able to. My brain wouldn't be able to handle it. Concussions, head injuries of any level, they're not worth playing the game. It's really about taking care of yourself. You have to look forward to things down in life, and if you can't take care of yourself in that moment, what's so important now? It's not worth playing on an injury, and it's important to take care of yourself in the moment.